heart failure is one of the leading killers worldwide, claiming a life about every 10 seconds. And despite important medical advancements, our core treatments for heart failure have remained virtually unchanged for decades. Discovering new effective drugs amongst the millions of possible chemical compounds is extremely challenging. But what if we had a tool, much like a flashlight, that could show us what the right drugs are? Through my thesis work, I will use a new molecular tool that I developed to help discover the next generation of heart failure medications. For many years, we have focused on a protein inside heart cells called CAMK2. Normally, CAMK2 ensures that the heart is beating at the appropriate rate and consuming the right amount of energy. In heart failure, however, CAMK2 becomes hyperactive and directly injures the heart. This made CAMK2 an immediate and exciting drug target. If we could make a drug to block its hyperactivity, we could prevent heart injury and death. This turned out to be easier said than done, since nearly 50 years after CAMK2's discovery, we still lack a blocker that is safe for human use. Addressing this problem has been difficult, in large part because of our inability to accurately track CAMK2 activity in living cells. This has left the field working in the dark, hoping to bump into the answers by chance. So I wanted to change this narrative, and I sought to develop an easy and robust method to measure CAMK2 activity. I engineered and validated a molecular sensor that detects CAMK2 in real time. My sensor can be introduced into living cells, and whenever CAMK2 is active, the sensor glows and lights up the cell. You can think of it as a light bulb that every cell carries and can only be switched on by CAMK2. Much like using a flashlight in a dark room, this sensor allows me to see the previously hidden dynamics of CAMK2 activity. More importantly, this sensor provides a thrilling opportunity to redefine the way we search for CAMK2 blockers. The traditional approach allows for testing of a few dozen or 100 drug candidates at a time. But by testing to see which chemicals reduce or completely eliminate the easy to detect signal from my sensor, we can look through thousands or millions of candidates all at the same time. In summary, the sensor I developed creates exciting possibilities for the remainder of my thesis. Not only does it allow for new heart biology to be seen and discovered, but perhaps more excitingly, it might provide the piece that has been missing for nearly half a century in order to develop a safe and effective CAMK2 blocker. With this new tool in our molecular arsenal, I aim to shine both a figurative and literal light on heart failure biology. Thank you.